Hello friends, welcome to my channel Botanical Studies. In this video, we will discuss about the fungus Mucor. First, the systematic position of Mucor. Mucor belongs to kingdom Plantae, subkingdom Cryptogams, division Eumycota, class Zygomycotina, subclass Zygomycetes, order Mucorales, family Mucoraceae, genus Mucor. Habit and occurrence of Mucor. Mucor is a saprophytic fungus, grows on dead organic matter, especially on cattle dung. There are 80 species of this genus occurring throughout the world. They are commonly called mold. Mucor are responsible for spoilage of bread, jam, jellies, pickles, cheese, syrups, leather, fruits, vegetables and plants. Somatic structure of mucor. The mycelium of mucor is highly branched, forms a fine network of hyphae. Hyphae are the cottony white thread-like, that is filamentous, aseptate or sinusitic. Some hypal branches penetrates into the substratum and absorbs the nutrients. These are called as absorptive hyphae. The cell wall is chitin, chitinosine, microfibrillar with polysaccharides, lipids, purine, pyrimidines, protein, calcium and magnesium. Inner to the cell wall, cell membrane is present which covers the protoplast. The protoplast contains many nuclei, mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, oil droplets, some vacuoles and other substances. Reproduction in mucor. Mucor reproduces by vegetative, asexual and sexual means. First, vegetative reproduction. It takes place by fragmentation. Due to accidental breakage, the mycelium may break up into two or more units. Each unit is capable to grow as a mother mycelium. Asexual reproduction in mucor. It takes place by the formation of oidia, by the formation of chlamydospores and formation of sporangiospores. Asexual reproduction in mucor by the formation of oidia. Oidia are thin-walled bead-like structure formed by mycelium. Grow in a medium rich in sugar. After detachment, the oidia increases by budding like yeast. This stage is called torula stage. Later on, they develop to new mycelium. Asexual reproduction in mucor by the formation of chlamydospores. During unfavorable conditions, thick-walled, nutrition-rich, intercalary mycelium segments are developed by septation of mycelium, which are termed as chlamydospores. When the connecting mycelium dries up, they get separated from each other. In favorable conditions, the chlamydospore germinates and gives rise to new mycelium. Asexual reproduction in mucor by the formation of sporangiospores. During favorable conditions, from the hyphae, first erect branched sporangiophore arises. Then maturation of sporangiophore occurs, where the cytoplasm and the nuclei push upwards. Due to this, the aerial hyphae solens at the apical end. After that, it develops a large round sporangium. Sporangium further divides the inner columella and upper sporoplasm. The nuclei in the sporoplasm divides into many thin-walled, non-motile uninucleate spores called sporangiospores. After breaking the wall of sporangium, the sporangiospores releases out. The spores remain dormant for some time, and when they obtain suitable substratum, they germinate to produce new mycelium. Sexual reproduction in mucor. At the time of sexual reproduction in heterothallic species, the two mycelia of compatible strains, that is positive strain mycelium and negative strain mycelium, come close to each other. The mycelia produces small outgrowth called progametangia. The apical region of the two progametangia come in close contact. Nuclei and cytoplasm of each progametangium push more and more towards the apical region and its tips swells up with a dense cytoplasm. This region becomes vacuolated. The septum is laid down, separating the apical region, which is called gametangium, and the basal region is called suspensor. The undifferentiated multinucleate protoplast of this gametangium is called synogamete. After maturation of gametangia, the common wall at the point of their contact dissolves, and the protoplast of both the gametangia unite to form zygospore. The nuclei of opposite gametangia fuse together to form diploid nuclei. Unpaired nuclei gradually degenerates. the diploid nuclei undergoes meiosis before resting stage of zygospores. In heterothallic species, normally 50% of nuclei are of plus strain and other 50% are of minus strain. All the nuclei except one degenerates, and the surviving nucleus undergoes repeated mitosis to produce large number of nuclei of the same strain. The young zygospore enlarges and probably secretes five-layered thick wall, two in exospore and three in endospore, of which outer one is black and warty. The zygospore then undergoes a period of rest. After resting period, the zygospore germinates. During germination, the innermost layer comes out after cracking the outer walls and produces a promycelium. The content of the zygospore migrated into the tip of promycelium, which swells up, differentiated into a lower stalk-like germ sporangiophore and the upper spherical germ zygosporangium. The haploid nucleus of germ sporangium forms haploid spores called sporangiospores inside the germ sporangium. These spores are also known as meiospores. Each meiospore, after liberation, germinates and form a new mycelium, like a mother thallus. Life cycle of mucor. Mucor is a saprophytic fungus growing on dead organic matter and responsible for spoilage of food. The mycelium of mucor is highly branched, forms a fine network of hyphae. Hyphae are cottony white, thread-like, filamentous, aseptate, or sinusitic. Mucor reproduces by vegetative, asexual, and sexual means. Vegetative reproduction by fragmentation, asexual reproduction by the formation of oidia, chlamydospores, and sporangiospores, and sexual reproduction by the formation of germ meiospores. Further, germinate to produce new mycelium. Economic importance of mucor. Mucor are responsible for spoilage of bread, jam, jellies, pickles, cheese, syrup, leather, fruits, vegetables, and plants. Some species of mucor contaminates air. Few species of mucor cause diseases, mucormycosis, in human beings. This is all about mucor.